welcome to Behind the Stunts. I'm John Alty. Thanks very much indeed for joining me once again this week. And what a show for you this week. We start with a gentleman who was born in Moscow in 1977. Martin Ivanov has been a major part of action cinema for the last 10 years. Starting with stunt driving on the Bourne Supremacy and the subsequent follow-up, the Bourne Ultimatum, Martin became a force to be reckoned with behind the wheel of a car. But it was with the 22nd James Bond adventure Quantum of Solace that Martin became known worldwide, doubling Daniel Craig in numerous shots in the fast-paced action pre-title sequence. He can be seen next year in the Jack Ryan Shadow Recruit picture and also in Expandables 3, doubling Jason Statham in some of the driving situations. And also, of course, the eagerly awaited November Men, which brings together Pierce Brosnan and Olga Kurylenko, of course, from Quantum of Solace. This is Martin Ivanov.
Есть такой человек, Мартин Иванов, который очень много сделал для этой сцены. И был дублером Мэтта Дэймона и проделал феноменальную работу. Это для него. Спасибо.
Traffic is stuck, and you're not moving anywhere. You thought you found a friend to take you out of this place. Someone you can lend a hand in return for grace. It's a beautiful.
Let it get away. You go there.
There we go. Not only extraordinary ability behind the wheel, but also as a stuntman general. I think it's very important to remember that. Yes, he came into the business with his rally driving background, but as you can see from that, he does it all. And he's going to be a major player, I know that for a fact, over the next few years to come. Very busy man, so keep an eye out for Martin Ivanov. Now, our classic for this week. What can be said about our classic stunt sequence for this week? It is, without question, my favourite TV show of all time. There were a number of British cop shows throughout the 70s. The Sweeney, The Professionals, which I loved. But this show really pushed my buttons. It had everything. It had a great cast. It had good stories. And more than anything else, for me, it had Roy Alon. A stuntman who could simply do it all. He was a high fall man who was just as comfortable behind the wheel of a car or on board a motorbike as he was falling through the air and landing in airbags. An extraordinary individual who, when he was given this show to arrange, really sank his teeth into every single action sequence. We're going to look at the conclusion to the original pilot episode, which was called Armed and Extremely Dangerous, where Makepeace, played by the very lovely Glynis Barber, is involved in a rooftop scuffle with one of the protagonists. And then this happens. I particularly like the way in which, from an editing perspective, they change the shot that you're looking at it from. They alter that the sequence and then play it slightly slow-mo just to take the full effect, the glory, the majesty of the man in action, Roy Alon falling 80 feet into an airbag. Incidentally, from the original clip there, that first shot that you see looking up at the building, you can see that he's falling from a platform which is a couple of floors lower down. But the sequence itself, the fall from the roof. There are many lovely stories about Roy and high falling. Roy always used to refer to, there was only a bunch of them at first, who did over 100 feet. 100 foot fall, as far as he was concerned, was like getting the lead in a West End play. It was a big do. And it got to the stage where there was five or six of them who were part of the Ton Up Club, 100 feet and above. And that's how they used to get these big jobs. So if there was a big high fall in a movie, chances are it was one of five people, and Roy was one of them. We'd had some lovely feedback when I mentioned that I was going to be covering this particular episode this week, and also some of the stories that Roy had brought from other people who'd worked with him. Tom Delmar, for instance, had mentioned that Roy was always very, very clever when it came to working out his fee. He would get the producer of the show to come up to the takeoff area and look down at the airbag where he was about to do the high fall and then negotiate his fee. Worked every time, apparently. Tom, of course, was Roy got Tom his first job in the industry, delivering airbags for that particular show, for Dempsey and Makepeace. So he has first-hand knowledge of just what a splendid fella Roy was. He was an absolute diamond, and I miss him very much. Roy, wherever you are, mate, we're still thinking about you. And that's a high fall. I mean, he would do that in his sleep, you know. And there was always So he'd be driving around and go, do you know, that'd be a great place to have a fall. He was always thinking about where to put the bag and how to get this particular sequence. And Dempsey and Makepeace was just an exceptional series. We are going to be doing a special about this particular show in the new year, so please keep an eye out for that. There will be a full-length show dedicated to Dempsey and Makepeace, and there will be all sorts of stuff going on in that. But for now, that is our sequence for this particular week, and that's us. So if you need anything, you know how to get in contact through the usual forms, via the social media or via the YouTube channel. Keep watching, keep subscribing, and stay safe. And we will see you all again next time. Thanks very much indeed for watching. Bye-bye for now.